So that is the back of the door, and as you can see, the screen here, or the glass, it's extremely dirty with probably oil and grease. So what I want to show you here is how I'm going to remove this grease, how I'm going to clean this door. Okay, so I put a half a cup here of baking soda. Now what I'm doing, I'm actually putting water here in this 3 1/4 cup. Okay, the 3 1/4 cup that I actually fill up, I'm not going to put all the water. And the most important is that we're going to create a consistent paste. So I'm just putting the water and I try to mix. And what I really want paste. So I put too much water here. A little bit too much water, so I'm actually going to put a little bit more baking soda, and a little bit more baking soda here, and I'm slowly getting this paste consistency. More that I have to get the paste consistency because I really want to spread it on the glass. And here is you can see it's like a milky stuff. Mix it, that's the most important. Okay. So as you can see, so now what I'm going to do, I'm going to actually spread it on the glass. I hope you have enough. Okay, now I'm going to take the sponge here and just spread it around the glass. Remember, I need to put it all over this glass because it's really, really dirty. Okay, now I'm going to leave it for 15 to 20 minutes. Okay, we actually come back here after 20 minutes actually. And you know, I'm using this sponge, put it in water a little bit and try to see what's happening here. You can see it's not easy. As you can see, we're cleaning, but it's not easy. So what we're going to use next, if it's not going to clean all, we're going to use a degreaser. But let's see how it works. Okay, as you can see, it's quite difficult. So what I decided to add, because I tried to do everything natural, I decided to add now a vinegar. And let's see what happened, because it's going to be a reaction here, as you can see. Let it work for like 1 or 2 minutes. Because this is very, very dirty, probably was never cleaned for like 3 or 4 years. And let's see if it will work. Okay, we're waiting like 2 minutes and let's see what happens. Yeah. As you can see, even if I dry strongly, it's a little bit getting out the grease, but it's not really enough, which means we will have to use some kind of degreaser here just to remove the rest. So we try natural, but it's actually difficult to remove. See what I'm doing here, I'm trying quite a bit, even stronger. See, you can take it out, but it's really tough. So what we're going to do now, we try to clean what we have here, and we'll go now and use the degreaser. Okay, so we'll continue. Then you can see the baking soda and the vinegar did not really work properly on this screen, on this window or glass, because this degreaser is probably for many years and it's actually stuck here so strongly, it's very difficult to remove it. So I have to use a different approach, and my approach is to use this degreaser, okay, I bought from Home Depot, and this should work. And what we're doing here, we just spread it from like maybe 6 or 10 inch from the surface. Also spray here, because there's also oil here on the metal. So we let it wait, we let it stay for like 3 or 4 minutes. And the reason it didn't clean the baking soda, because this dough was not cleaned for many years. So if you clean it every month or two, it probably will work perfectly. So we are 5 minutes after, and let's see what's happening here, if it's easy to remove it. Because remember, it sticks to the glass. You can see the degreaser did not really work also. So let's see on the metal. In the metal it's worked perfectly. Okay, so here it really worked. And you can see. You can see how on the metal it worked. But on the glass, even if I scratch it strongly, you can see that the result is quite similar to the baking soda. So now we need to go and have different approach to try to remove this sticky grease or oil. Okay, so we use baking soda, we use degreasers, and as you can see, the burnt, that's a oil that actually sitted for a long time, actually become like a solid degrease. We couldn't take it out, you know, for 20 minutes, 30 minutes putting a baking soda on it. The trick here is you have to put 24 hours, but if you don't want to put 24 hours, let me show you what I'm doing. I'm actually using this scraper. It costs like $1 from Lowe's or from Home Depot. You can see the blade is here. And what I'm doing, actually moving it here. Okay. You don't really need to wait 24 hours. You can see what's happening here, how is the degreaser is going. But that's actually after I put baking soda for 20 minutes. So I can continue like that. You can see how the burnt is getting out of it. So you can see the amount of grease that I actually use a scraper here just to remove it. And also from here and from here I can remove the burnt very easily with this scraper. And by the way, this scraper works better than any chemical that I use, including baking soda. As you can see how easy it is to remove it. So I'll continue just removing it and I'll show you the result very soon. So now I can take a piece of paper and just put these degrees of burnt. So you can see the amount of burnt and removed with this scraper, quite easy. It's better than any chemical or baking soda because it's working very fast with no problem. Okay, after I remove the grease, all this burnt, I can actually apply again the degreaser, the chemical degreaser, and try to remove it. After I finish with this scraper, okay, I'm actually taking a wet paper. Okay, it's a bounty paper, and just move around here on the glass, on the area here. You can see. You can see how dirty it is. It's all the remain of the oil, but if you look here, and I can show you from a close distance, there are still spots of oil here that I will have to remove it with either baking soda or with a greaser. So let's go to the next step. So that's the way it looks so far. So if you can to look at it from close distance, you can see there are still oil spots here. Okay, let's probably I have to use a soap or a degreaser here. The rest look quite clean. Okay, so here is the result after the scraper. And remember, I used baking soda for like 20 minutes and it just made it a little softer, but it did not remove it. And then I used the degreaser, but also it did not remove it, didn't remove the brand. The only thing I use here is actually scraper. So the reason for that is that the recommendation is to put, if you have a brand, the recommendation is to put the baking soda for 24 hours, but I didn't have this time to wait 24 hours, so I used this scraper that cost like $1.38. So now what left us to do is just to use a simple all-purpose cleaner, and it's natural, as you can see, and I'm just going to spray it. And let it stay for 3 minutes. Okay, now what I'm using warm water, between warm to hot water here. I'm using this sponge. As you can see, this is the rough area. I put it in hot water and I'm starting to clean the last oil. So I'm using a paper, a bounty paper, or a paper towel, and I'm starting to clean. You can see how it looks like. So all the oil is really getting out of the window. So here is the end result of the cleaning of the glass. Okay, but if you really want to just shining and make it a little shiny, you can use a simple glass cleaner with no ammonia in it. Okay, like this one, glass cleaner. Just after you clean it, you just want to make it shining. So you can actually just use it, spray, and wipe it out with a bounty paper. and I'll show you the result, how it's going to look like. So that's the way it looks from close proximity. As you can see, it's quite clean. So that's the way the glass looks. You can see how clean it is. There is not even any memory of what used to be on this glass before. And the other side of it, that is the other side.